Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Aquablade11, and it is my greatest pleasure to welcome you all to the Pokémon Soul Silver Insanity Nuzlocke. Now, if you are new to my videos, let me give you a bit of backstory as to what this is and what I'm doing. Pokémon Soul Silver has been long regarded by me as my favorite entry in the Pokémon franchise. Just my opinion. I like all of them in their own way, but this one has my favorite stuff. So, I wanted to do something very special with it. I attempted to do this at one point with a series called The Quest of the Chosen Six, which was a playthrough where I tried to complete the game, basically. I used a single team of six, I caught every single Pokemon I found, I defeated every single trainer I could find, but I didn't enjoy that very much. I found it more to be a chore than actually enjoyable. So I decided that, you know what, I'll come back to Soul Silver when it's my final playthrough I will ever do on YouTube. And guess what? That's where we are. So, but what does that mean? Does that mean this is the last playthrough you'll ever do? No one's needed because I'm a master. I'm a Pokemon master, duh. Looks like the sun is descending in the sky. This would be what is called twilight. No! Do not associate that word with this game! It's been really hard explaining things when I'm reading things, just so you all know. World of Pokemans. Okay, guys, this is an opening of a Pokemon game. I'm assuming you know what's going on here, so I'm not gonna bother reading any of this, alright? Just so we're clear. So, final playthrough on YouTube. This could be the final Nuzlocke I do on the channel Aquablade11. And that's just a possibility. So please don't freak out or anything in case you missed the memo or, you know, I started this whole explanation by saying if you're new to my videos, then why would you care if I'm leaving? You don't even know who I am. Well, whatever. Am I a boy or a girl? I am a man, but I will go with boy just because that's the closest equivalent. Anyway. Pokemon Soul Silver. Insanity Nuzlocke. I enjoy Nuzlockes. They are my favorite type of playthrough to do through on Pokemon games. So, it only makes sense for me to do a Nuzlocke of my favorite game, right? But I can't just do any wimpy, simple Nuzlocke. I've already done way too many crazy Nuzlockes at this point for a simple one to cut it. No! We're gonna combine everything I've done so far! Every single playthrough I've done so far will have an impact on this one in terms of rules. Well, you can argue at least that. Every single rule that's in this is either brand new or somewhat modified version of a previous rule I've used in my past playthroughs. Let me start with the basics of how a Nuzlocke works. Basically, if a Pokemon faints during battle, you're dead. It's dead. It's gone. You can't use it again. The end. So, alright, that's fine. Fine, I'll just catch whatever I want. I'll just catch a bunch of Pokemon and have a whole big giant team and not worry how many die. Yeah, can't do that. You can only catch the first Pokemon you encounter per route. I'm currently looking for a cool window type to have. I'll probably find one after I loop around like three times. Ooh, clouds. I might do that one. I know I did this blue one, this one right here, for the Soul Silver Quest of the Chosen Six. I don't want to copy that one. Let's do this cloud. I like clouds, because it will actually match something I'm doing in this playthrough. So the first one, that's fine. Okay, first one of every route. Alright, we'll count up all the routes. You get about 50-something Pokemon. That's still quite a lot. Alright, okay, fine. I'll see what you're coming with here. What if I limit which ones I'm allowed to catch? What if they have to be a certain type? That's right, I am bringing over a rule from my duo-type Nuzlocke, as it's called, where I can only catch two types of Pokemon. However, this playthrough, since it has a bunch of new rules added in, I'm actually allowing myself to catch three different types of Pokemon, not two. And we're gonna talk to this random guy over here. Dot, dot, dot. So this is the famous Elm Pokemon Lab. What are you staring at? Your red hair. It's very pretty. He looks like a pretty girl, right? I don't know what you guys think, but that's what I thought when I first saw that person. Anyway, getting about my research, I have no idea who you are, dude! Anyway, now some of you are thinking that might be easy, because, you know, I've already succeeded in a playthrough where I've done only two types of Pokemon, but this one's gonna have a lot more rules! And there's 16 badges to get, unlike the other ones which have only had 8. So, my three types, I'm gonna have to tell you one of them right off the bat, because one of them is one of the three starter types. Since this could potentially be my final playthrough, I wanted one of my three types to be my favorite. Grass. Grass is my favorite type of the game. So grass is one of my types, so spoilers, I'm gonna pick Chikorita. And it looks like I'm doing that right now. I guess I gotta explain the other types when I'm going, so... But I'll just say right now, my favorite Pokemon of all time is Feraligatr. Unfortunately, it looks like we're never gonna see him in this playthrough. That is unfortunate, but I don't care. I want Chikorita because grass is one of my types in this playthrough. Give a nickname to Chikorita. Alright, I guess we're also gonna talk about my nicknaming theme. It's a male. My nicknaming theme. Basically, I'm not gonna have a set theme this time, but yes, I sort of am. Every nickname I give my Pokemon in this playthrough will reference something in a past video of mine. So it could be a character from one of my Sprite stories. It could be referencing a nicknaming theme of a past nicknaming theme of a playthrough. It could be the name of a character from the same franchise of something that I referenced. It could be really obscure is what I'm saying. I could really stretch the references if I wanted to. But we're not going to stretch too far for some of these nicknames. For this Chikorita, I got to think for a second. All right, I know exactly who the name of this is going to be. This Meganium is going to be named Semula. Semula, for those who are unaware, is the name of a character from my story known as Zukunov. Dogmas of the Quiet Past, if you want to be this specific. I'm also not reading this opening because I've played this game a billion times, and I'm assuming you guys have seen this game before. If this is your first time seeing HeartGold or SoulSilver, this is not probably the recommended playthrough for you to watch. Just an FYI. Semula is the name of one of the three nations in that series. The nation of nature. So, grass. Grass, plants, and even wind sometimes. But it's also the name of the person who founded the nation, who is known of a weapon called the Flower Lance. Flowers, Meganium has to get a giant flower around his neck, so that's how I got that name. Semula! Hello, Semula, welcome to the team. Doesn't seem to be used to its own name yet. Don't worry, you'll get used to it, just like everyone else who watches looking up, right? You all got used to all the names? You better have. Anyway. So, I already told you, only it's only one of my types. My favorite type of the game is grass. I thought, okay, if he's my favorite type, let's do my least favorite type. Rock. Rock is my least favorite type of the game because low accuracy moves, lots of weaknesses, and just unreliability, in my opinion. So, rock is one of the other two types I can use to balance my favorite type. So, a third type. What do I do for a third type? Well, I thought about it. I picked one specifically. I didn't, like, just... there's a lot of reasons why I picked this type. It is flying is my third type. Why flying? Well, it's kind of in the middle of my list of favorite types. I have a top 17 types video from a long time ago, so, you know, you can already tell because it's top 17. It doesn't have fairy included, so it's old. But, and it's pretty bad, so don't watch it. But it still holds true mostly for my opinions. At least my favorite and least favorite. Around the middle somewhere is flying. Not only is that good because it's around the middle, so it would balance my favorite and least favorite, but I feel like it balances the other types just in terms of, you know, how good the other types are and what types they're good against and weak against. So those are my three types of Pokemon I can catch. So that's basically how this works. Once I came to obtain Pokeballs, which I don't have them yet, so none of this stuff really counts. So any encounter I find, since they don't have Pokeballs, they don't even count. So, I will find an encounter, right? If it is flying, grass, or rock, I can catch it. If it's not, I try again, and you try to get a different encounter. Alright, my first encounter was Pidgey. Spoilers, we're most likely gonna get Pidgey on this route anyway. Because that's the only flying type available on this route, unless I'm playing at night, in which case it would be Hoot Hoot. So I have to make sure I'm playing at night at some point so I can get a Hoot Hoot. But anyway, so that's it. I can catch this Pidgey. If it was a Rattata, per se, I would not be able to catch it, and I would have to try again and look for a Pidgey. Or another flying type if they were available. But let's say, so I catch Pidgey on this route, right? And then I see another Pidgey on the next route. Wrong! Cannot catch a second Pidgey, or any duplicates for that matter. So basically, I get one of every evolution line of grass, rock, or flying types of this game, assuming I actually find them. Because there's always this situation where, well, let's say, let's pretend on the off chance, this was the only route in the game you could find Pidgey, but I happen to find something else. Let's say I find Hoot Hoot on the off chance, you know, pretend you could find them both at the same time of the day. I find Hoot Hoot. But Hoot Hoot's also available on the next route, but Pidgey is not. That means I lost Pidgey because of luck. I didn't run into it. I did not get Pidgey. So, there is no guarantee I will get necessarily one of every single evolution line out there. Because things I just said. And also, I should probably get to the next one. You guys are probably like questioning because it's been on the screen ever since I was in some point in Elm's lab. And I may be in trouble now that I'm thinking about it. So I may want to start running away from things. But anyway, you saw when I was in my... Okay, fine. Slow down here. I'm done with my rule about catching Pokemon. Only one of the three different types available, and they have to be the first one I encounter on that route. Assuming it's not a duplicate and stuff like that. I want to get to another level. I can survive more attacks. I'm fine. I can always run if need be. You saw in my options, I set battle style to set. That's a rule I have been using in my Nuzlockes for the last several, which basically means I can't switch Pokemon automatically when I've defeated the Pokemon of the blah blah trainer. You guys know how that works, right? I would hope so. All right, well, let me look at Samuel real quick. I didn't look at him yet. Serious nature. All right, so he's very serious on this playthrough. I like that. Very, very serious. Yeah, that's that. Battle style on set. Next rule. I'm gonna start running from things. Hold on. You may notice on the screen there is a thing called healing points. And I should only have one half right now. In fact, let me write that down on my little piece of paper because I don't see what's on the screen. What you see on the screen is edited. So, how do I have half a healing point? What the heck is even a healing point? Well, in my past Insanity Nuzlockes, I had a system known as healing points. Fun fact. Basically, I can only heal at every single Pokemon Center or equivalent once. But I didn't have to use it right away. I could carry it over to the next one if I wanted to. So I simplified this to a system where if I run into a new Pokemon Center or equivalent, I gain a healing point and I can use it anytime. But they always turned out to be not that big of a challenge. The only exception was when I first added the rule, which was in my Platinum Insanity Nuzlocke, but that also included a rule that I don't want to have in this one. And in my Sapphire Nuzlocke, which I got a full team sweep, and I had to train a whole new team of Pokemon, and yeah, I ended up using a good amount of healing points. But I still didn't run out of them. And then lastly, with Alpha Sapphire, I had 7 left over by the end. So basically, they didn't add that much challenge. So how can I improve upon this? I only gain half a healing point upon reaching a new spot. So I can only use every other Pokemon Center or equivalent. So now that I found a second Pokemon Center, I now have 2. And some might be thinking that I can use my mom to heal, so doesn't that mean I have 1.5? No. I don't believe Mother heals you in this game. I might be proven wrong, but I don't believe she does heal you in this game because instead, Professor Elm has a healing spot in his lab. I'm gonna buy some potions because they're gonna be really necessary. I guess I already had some, so I didn't need to worry when I was in those battles. Next rule. Can't heal during battle. Now that rule might not sound that bad at first, but that is without a doubt the hardest rule you could add in any playthrough. I'm serious. The hardest new rule, fair rule, the hardest fair rule you can add to a playthrough. Trust me on this. You don't know that until you've tried it. Not being able to heal during battle is really hard. Top that off with the fact that I have limited amounts of healing, and that I have battle style on set. Not an easy Nuzlocke. So, you know what, these are all pretty hard, but you know what, let's go further! Let's go further, come on! This might be my final playthrough, right? We gotta go all out! Next rule! You know, mommy in this game, like I just said, she might not heal you? That's because she serves a different function in this game. She takes your money from you! I'm just running from battle, just so you're all aware. She takes money from you, if you choose her to. I'm gonna have her do that! Now that might not sound like that bad of a rule, but here's this. I can never get money back from her. Now why is this such a bad thing? Why is this adding hard rules? Well, because I'm basically just trying to make the healing points rule harder. Basically, I never ran short of money or healing items in Insanity Nuzlockes in the past, ever. It was never a problem. So it was like, I might as well not even have the healing points. Because, I mean, it's not like I'm running low on healing items at all. So guess what? I'm limiting the amount of money I earn throughout the game. My mom will take a cut of it, and I'm not allowed to withdraw any from her. However, I can use the items she buys for me. I think that's fair, right? I can use the items she buys for me, but I cannot withdraw money from her, ever. I don't know if that's going to add that much of a challenge, but I did want to limit the amount of money I get in this game. Because it's really not that hard to get a lot of money in Pokemon games. So, hopefully that will make it slightly harder, but I wouldn't be surprised if it doesn't help too much. Next up, Pokemon cannot be intentionally leveled past the highest level Pokemon of the next gym leader. So, for example, Falkner is the first gym leader. His Pidgeotto is at level... hold on, let me look that up. Falkner's Pidgeotto, his best Pokemon, is at level 13. Therefore, I am not allowed to train my Pokemon intentionally past level 13. Because that's a little cheating, in my opinion. To just always be over-leveled. No, I can either be even or lower. But, you know, what if I don't do any extra training? What if I don't intentionally do any training, and I'm just, you know, playing through the game normally, but I still over-level well? Then I'm going to make an exception. But we'll see if that ever happens. I'm just throwing that out there just in case it happens. But basically, yeah. Oh my goodness! Something just happened! He healed my Pokemon without my approval. So guess what? I lost half a healing point right there. Do you know how? Why did I lose half a healing point right here? Because I reached a new healing spot. Mr. Pokemon, he is a new healing spot. So I gained a half. But he just used it. So I lost one. So I lost a net of half. One half. So, and that sucks. Instead of now, from now on, being like, oh yay, free healing point. No, it's bad when they heal me. Because they're using my healing points without my permission. So that is bad. And I don't know if there's like a guide out there somewhere that lists all these happenings throughout the game, but I'm not gonna look them up if there are. So there's gonna be like freak times that we don't want you to heal me. Isn't that a weird, contradictory thing to want to think? No, don't heal my Pokemon. That's bad. You're using up my healing points. So, that's an interesting. I didn't mention that when I was talking about it. When I was talking about that rule, because I knew that part was going to happen. I was saving to say that when that happened. So, can we really pile any more rules on top of this? Can we really pile any more stupid rules on top of this stupid challenge? I got one more. So, I can't use healing items, right? What about healing moves, like recover? Alright, I actually decided to fight that Pidgey that I just found in that encounter, so I did get hurt. Healing moves like Recover, Morning Sun, Moonlight, and the like. Cannot use those either. And honestly, that was actually established when I didn't know what I should learn for when I was trying to forget moves. You know, I think it's just easier for everyone if I can't use those at all. Because, I don't know. I don't, think they're really fair, in my personal opinion. But I could totally understand someone arguing against that statement. And I'm not against if people are. So, that's all the rules of this challenge. Now that we've actually established all these rules, let me know what you think of this. So far. I know it might seem like a lot of rules and I'm overcomplicating things, but this might be my final Nuzlocke. So I want it basically to be a combination of everything I've done so far, plus more. And it's my favorite game, so... And I feel really bad that I'm not reading all the stuff that comes by, because I really do enjoy the dialogue of these characters, like my rival, for example. Passerby Boy is his name in this game. Critical hit, yay! I may wonder why I used Razor Leaf and not Tackle. Well, I think Razor Leaf is stronger. Do the damage calculations. Tell me if a stab, not very effective, Razor Leaf is stronger or not than a 4th gen Tackle. 4th gen Tackle is only 40 base power. So yeah, pretty sure that Razor Leaf is stronger, but I could be wrong. But it does miss. So can Tackle though, so that really doesn't change anything. So yeah, I really don't know what to say. This whole episode was basically just me explaining the rules of this challenge. Hopefully you guys enjoy this. I feel like that did less than the rest of the attacks did. Like, that was almost crap. But whatever. I really hope you guys look forward to this challenge. I know I'm gonna have a ton of fun with it because I love this game. And I'm gonna have lots of nicknames referencing my past videos. And wow, Omi almost grew a second level. Humph, are you happy you won? Generally, victory does come with happiness, yes. I'm the world's greatest Pokemon trainer! And yeah, I think I've mentioned this in the Quest of Chosen 6, but I really like how in the Heart Gold Soul Silver rendition of this, they changed his encounter dialogue to reflect that you found out his name, but don't say it out loud, as opposed to in Gold Silver Crystal, he literally flat out says, "My name is Triple Question Mark." So when I was little, I always thought that's what you were supposed to tell the police officer when it asks you for, what was his name? Well, officer, he said his name was Triple Question Mark. So when my friend told him the wrong name, when I was watching him play, I was like, no, dude, that's not his name. You're playing the game wrong. But then it actually called the guy that name. And I was like, oh, well, that was a stupid way to make me name my rival. Why would you make the rival say, hello, my name is this, but you actually be able to name him? So yeah. That just might have been me, a little kid logic, not being able to understand that's what was going on. Because I think when you are naming him, it does say enter rival's name. So maybe I was supposed to infer from that information. But also, whoever that guy is, he clearly stole the wrong Pokemon. Why would he steal a Cyndaquil? He should have stole Totodile. Because that evolves the Feraligatr, the best Pokemon you could possibly have. So, alright, this red guy's name, I really do like Silver as a rival, guys, so, like I've done before, I'm just gonna name him Silver, because I like taking him seriously. He's a really good rival, he's my favorite rival, personally. Very good character and all that crap that, you know, makes a character good, in my opinion. So, his name is Silver. Because this is Soul Silver! Alright, this is terrible. Oh yes, what was the discovery? Yay, an egg. He discovered eggs. I'm glad he discovered eggs, because eggs are very yummy. And speaking of this egg, Togepi evolves into Togetic, a flying type. I guess I didn't mention this part. This is something, if you watch the Duotype Nuzlocke, you'd know. But let me explain anyway. If a Pokemon can evolve into a type that I can get, such as Togetic, I think that's how you pronounce his name, I can get its pre-evolution, but if it evolves and loses its type, I cannot evolve it. For example, Scyther. I may get a Scyther at some point in this game, I might not. It all depends on my luck in the National Park during the bug-catching contest. I can't evolve into Scizor because I'd lose my flying type. So I hope that all makes sense. But Togepi I can use. The question is, what route do I consider I caught it on? Technically, I got the egg on that route going up to Mr. Pokemon's house, but I don't even technically receive in my party until Violet City. I don't think there isn't another Pokemon I can get in Violet City, so I think I'm gonna make it my encounter for Violet City, now that I'm thinking about it. So here's the next rule I have to do. Save your prize money, and no, my mother did not heal me. Did not heal me, so we talked. Welcome, hope you're doing fine, I see. Kept everyone trying to get your money. See, she does not heal you in this game. She does not heal you in this game, so she's not worth a healing point. Alright, I think we're gonna catch us our first Pokemon before we move on to the next episode. I'm sorry if this is a long first episode. I don't know how long I want these episodes to be quite honest with you. So, you can get 12 Pokemon Pokeballs! Thanks! Thank you so much, Lyra. I'm gonna skip this tutorial. I'm sure you all know how to catch Pokemon. Alright, yep, Lyra did the thing. She caught the Pokemon! She did it. Good job, Lyra. You are a good trainer. You know how to catch Rattata. Alright, let us run and catch us Pidgey. It's going to be Pidgey, guys, unless I randomly get Hoot Hoot somehow. Nope, it's Pidgey. Level 2 female Pidgey. Alright, that's exactly what we found last time, but we killed it. Let's use Tackle. And that did okay. Also, if I kill it, I don't get a retry. But if I do kill it, I can potentially catch a different Pidgey on another route. But just in case Semula decides to be a critical hit person, we're gonna throw a ball. Ta-da! We got us a Pidgey! Aw, yeah! Now, I was trying to think of a nickname for this thing while I was watching Lyra catch the thing, but I couldn't think of anything, so I gotta think for a nickname of this. If you guys have any suggestions for nicknames I could potentially use, that would be references to things in my past videos, and what Pokemon you think they would fit for, please be more than free to suggest. Because I'm going to have a hard time thinking of nicknames for this, to be quite honest with you all. Let me think of something. I'll be right back. Alright, I got a name. This nickname is a throwback to my nicknaming theme from my white duo-type Nuzlocke, Colors. This is Celeste. Celeste is actually a light blue, according to my list of color nicknames that I never used, ended up using. That I still have a list of that. So, I thought Celeste sounded kind of like a female name of something that would work for a flying type. But who knows? That's just my thoughts. I could be wrong. I think it sounds like a nice name, though. So, a quirky nature and likes to thrash about. Alright, that's not bad. So, we've got two neutral natures so far. That's alright. So, that's all we've got for the first episode. So yeah, please let me know if you have any nickname suggestions for the future Pokemon I could get. And also, before I go, I want to remind you guys something, in case you missed the memo. I've actually begun a playthrough of Pokemon Conquest Blind on a second channel known as Blue Gator Gaming. I will have a link to it in the description below and in every video from now on. and there will be a link to the first episode of it at the end of this video. So please check that out if that sounds interesting to you. Because I'm also on that channel, I'm planning to do a non-Pokemon playthrough this week, actually. So yes, I'm going to be starting a second playthrough at the same time on that channel. So I'll be doing a grand total of 3 playthroughs, if you're following all three. Both channels, that is. So I look forward to what's in the future, and I'll be looking forward to this challenge, because I think I'm going to have a lot of fun with it. So yeah, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Rock on.